Alone, it gets lonely. And today, a good friend here in the world of YouTube has agreed to keep company with me. I haven't held him against his will. He's here free will, people. And we're here at Passyunk, aren't we?
Yeah.
My man Max. Max versus food.
Hey, how's it going? Thanks for having me, man. It's really good to be here. It's really good to finally have a showdown. You know, strong arm you into a challenge, either.
No. I mean, he's been nice to me, people. This guy, if you've seen any of his videos, then you'll know. If you don't know, then he is the challenge master. Just done a Passyunk cheesesteak challenge, so he's managed to eat a Philly cheesesteak in within 57 seconds. And just take a look at that.
That one there.
Big daddy. We're not playing around. And not only has he done that, he's also agreed to do another video, a food review video, with me straight after. So it's not like we're back 2 days later. No, we're in it. We're in the midst of it. We've got three Philly cheesesteaks, we've got some buffalo wings, we've got some Cajun fries, and some
Tater tots.
Tater tots, can't go wrong. Some classic American diner food here.
I think we have to go with classic first. So this is Cheese Whiz, which is like, well, you can't get Cheese Whiz in England actually. So this is like homemade in-house. All the stuff here is homemade, which sounds really amazing. The bread is like what makes Philly cheesesteaks. It's legit from here.
I think we should just dig in, bro.
Let's do it, man.
Oh my God. What do I say? Say another bite.
It's really good. The cheese, like, people wouldn't originally think of like Cheese Whiz as being something that you go for, but it really makes it.
Not only does it taste right, it's just cooked to perfection.
I do like food challenge videos, it's a bit different, as you can see, because I've already eaten like all of mine and you're like on your second bite.
I don't talk a lot.
But like, it definitely is the passion there to like, you have to have a passion to be able to like do it outside of your day job. For like us as like hobbyists, I think that's what makes it a bit different from like all the other YouTubers or like Instagram people out there who like do it for their living, and I really respect that. It's really cool, but I think there's an added little bit of element to us for the passion of like, you just do this outside of your job.
I've been watching his videos over the last couple months, I'd say, and I'm just gobsmacked at how, you know, doesn't waste the food, eats it all up, and so gracefully, looks so healthy. So, you know, there's a side of food that we don't really show, which is feeling sluggish. It can be quite unhealthy, and there's a balance that's needed. And the proof is in the pudding. I mean, he's chiseled and cut like an action figure. So, you know, what's the secret is what I'm trying to get to. I'm having an Oprah Winfrey moment here.
I don't know, it is dedication. To put yourself in that position to like, you know, really want to eat a load of food and stuff like that, you have to practice, and you have to like really practice kind of like, you know, doing capacity, you know, really big challenges like speed and stuff like that. But I also take that across to like the fitness side of things as well. Like fitness is why I got into this actually. For I was doing food challenges to bulk, like that would be my cheat meals, and I do really big cheat meals. And I go, and then after I just went along to like Man vs Food, like a restaurant, and did a challenge there, and then got entered into a competition, and then from that competition it just kind of like expanded from there. But originally it was to like bulk, and I had a couple of injuries here and there, but like that's the reason why I do it. I kind of get to be able to do like food challenges as well, like have a bit more of a better relationship with food as well. It sounds a bit weird because I'm a bit extreme in the food diet.
Like, no, it makes sense.
But now I know that I can eat all this, and then I know I can work off the gym and have a really like quite a good balance about it. It works well for me.
I finally caught up with you and finished the Philly cheesesteak. That was the classic one with the G beers. I'm gonna go grab a fork, go for a pop top. I was gonna say pop top, but potatoes were
really nice. They're really crispy. Tater tots, like as opposed to any other type of like potato one, like chips can be a bit like soggy and not that nice, but like the whole crisp on the outside and the chewiness on the inside really makes it.
But I think I'm gonna go with the chips as well. I don't know about you, man. Are you into chips?
The reason why I don't is because like if you lots of food chain, that's where they add the bulk. They're like, oh, here's like a burger and here's like 5 pounds of chip.
But what do you think?
Those are really nice. They've got a flavouring in them.
Gilbey? Oh, yeah, it's like a Cajun seasoning.
But more kind of smoky in that sense. It's really nice, actually. Yeah,
it's really stood out.
This is the Reading Hill Terminal one. It is like a really famous market in Philadelphia, and it has like amazing food stalls there. And this is named after it.
So it's ribeye steak with provolone cheese, tender stem broccoli, pesto sauce on the bread, and then sprinkled with Parmigiano.
Never had it with like tender stem broccoli. It's gonna be an experience.
So that means you're telling me that I won't feel guilty because I'm having broccoli.
The texture though from the tender stem broccoli is really, really nice. I really like the shavings. The Parmesan shavings are really, really good on it. I think it's the bread as well. Definitely, like, it looks, when I see these, it looks like it's gonna be like a baguette. And the bread's just really, really soft. Holds it together really well.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah, praise the Lord.
Just had to take a moment and have a little prayer for this good ass steak.
That broccoli, that crunch that adds, it's just so well. I'm not supposed to be eating more.
Just keep doing it, man. Till we need a forklift to get out of here. That's the goal. I think that's gonna have to be our clickbait title for this video.
Two men taken out by a forklift. As like amateurs or hobbyists, like I can't do more than I found a balance of like one challenge a week, maybe something a bit like this is like a night off, but I can't do more than that. Not for the health benefits or anything like that really. It's more just like editing or just like being able to like coordinate it and everything like that.
Logistics is really high level rated, so here us reviewing food together, you know, that's something new that I haven't really done before. I'm assuming the same for you.
Like I don't often do this for a channel, so yeah, let me know in the comments like how you like the reviewing and stuff like that as well. So it's quite good. It's fun to do different content, although I'm gonna strong arm you into a challenge one day, even if it's a little one. Definitely I'm gonna get you down here to do some type of challenge.
I want one of those t-shirts.
Yeah, you do.
So
yes.
In that note, we should just do the wings. Buffalo wings, baby. Buffalo wings. Don't mind if I do.
I love that. I really want to do that in my... I want like catchphrases. I don't have any catchphrases. I need catchphrases. This is what I've been missing. I had these a couple of weeks ago. I really like... It's that little bit of Frank's red hot sauce. A little bit of a tang to it. You know, some of them are like really, really breaded. And like too... Like just too thick. Like too much breading and not enough chicken. I really like these are thick. I've also had a lot of wings in my time now. I'm definitely racking up the wing count there.
This is like elite level sh**. You gotta come here. Tell me what you think about these wings. Because these are special.
I like the fact that you just do like one like variety and not like, oh, we're gonna do hundreds of different ones. And then they always muddies like the actual, like, hone it down on one type of wing. Do you have like a food group or type that you kind of like to do more of, or that you kind of swing more towards?
Burgers. Kind of, it's in the logo,
but
it's not like the limit, it's not all I do, but it's kind of like my go-to. That's what I'm really enjoying is cheesesteaks. The buns, people slip up on the buns a lot. Like I say, hard to cut corners, and this one has just amplified that experience. We're going to try that dip now, which we neglected, and, you know, take it as a backhanded compliment, because it's so good without it. Good amount.
Whoa. See, look at my terrible wing. You were telling me before I should have done the whole. Look at this. This is just. You think I know how to eat wings after I ate like 8 of them? But
I'm terrible.
That's a statement. I know. I'm so terrible at it. Like, what have I done here?
But ultimately, you made me feel guilty about not cleaning the wings properly. So I went back to one that I ate earlier. Nibbled it a bit more.
Definitely the mix of the blue cheese and the wings really makes it. I think it cools it down a little bit.
Yeah.
But it's so strong, like, they're just really, both really strong flavours though.
Yeah.
They work well. It's the saltiness with that spotlight, a spiciness, I think I like.
What blue cheese should be, I think this is kind of nailed it.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be potent in that sense. Something like that.
Look at it.
If you were to go with or without getting controversial, you know, EastEnders can have drama, why can't we? So, on that note, you prefer the wings with or without the blue cheese?
I'm quite a purist, so I like it without, and I think
diplomatic, man. Where's the drama in that?
Because as well, like, in the back of my mind, it's like you won't get flavor fatigue. This is where it's like a food challenge.
Yeah, yeah, that's
you won't get flavor fatigue. Water, make it basic, don't put loads of condiments on it. Like it for what it is, and then if you don't like it, then, or like you want to change up the flavours, then add that stuff in.
I agree with you basically, but why I like that more Tucker's soaked up the Frank sauce. Flavor Town, man.
Yeah, they're really faithful, but also the crunch as well.
So we've got here
South Philly Chicken Farm, so that is breaded chicken with provolone cheese, homemade Italian marinara sauce, which is a secret recipe, so no one else can know. Sprinkled with Parmesan cheese on our homemade bread. Bon appetit.
Ooh-wee. This is the one I've been looking forward to, actually, because this is like the unusual one as well. Look how that is.
I know.
Thick.
This is
that
like
is girthy.
Oh, my choice of words precisely.
I was not expecting that. It is definitely like a pasta sauce.
We went from Philadelphia to Italy within 2 bites.
Chicken's really good as well. It's like breaded as well. That makes it really, really nice. It's just another kind of contrast, a bit of texture to it. Like I said, it's not like tomato sauce. It's much more like got that really nice texture of cheese in it.
Mm-hmm.
Really nice, like adds that sweetness as well. Really good. And there's a lot to it as well.
This one's really filling. The chicken pieces are really thick.
Ah, yeah, your team.
Wiggling my pickle. As I've grown older, I've learned to appreciate it more because I felt like it cleanses the palate. It breaks up from all like the meat you eat.
Really. It's kind of underrated because everyone's like, I think England as well. They're so like, because people grow up with like gherkins, probably mostly from like a McDonald's burger, and people are like, nah, take it out, and like they don't appreciate like American fare and food and putting a pickle on the side to do that exactly, that contrast, and also the texture contrast as well.
100%.
I'm surprised as well, like, I did a challenge beforehand, but we haven't struggled at all to eat this, like, we just eat a lot of food.
We have, haven't we? Maybe I will take on a challenge then.
Yeah. I think, but it's your passion as well, like, you don't want to limit, that's what I found a little bit as well, that's why I like doing the food challenge a little bit, because I know, I think it depends on where you are in your life and stuff like that, but like, I know I could do a lot of food challenges, but when I could get big, and like, I could be like, you know, I don't like the look of how I am, but you can train, you know, you just cut down, you make smart choices, you be active, you do cardio, like, I'd always suggest people do that anyway, and then you can slim down, like, that's what the thing, like, my crazy challenge, like, I've eaten, like, 13,000 calories in one sitting, and then I know that I'm gonna feel awful, like, directly after, maybe the next day, but in a couple of days' time, it will come and like you can work that off. It's not, you know, that one bite you're not gonna regret for, you know, once on the lips and then the lifetime on the hips just isn't the case. Like I don't think that's the case. I think you can just do it smart and you can enjoy your food and then you have that better relationship with it. Like, I definitely feel like I've got a lot better relationship with food now that I actually do these things, because I could do this meal and before I'd be like, oh my god, I have loads of cheesesteak, blah blah, but I know that I could do a little bit of cardio tomorrow, I could maybe not have a bit of a lighter meal, or maybe not, and I just, you know, use it on a really heavy workout where I work out for like 2 hours.
Yeah, I think you hit the nail on the head there. Is it really to do with mindset then? Because you can get stuck in being sluggish and not doing much because you're like feeling lazy or like you're in a food coma.
I see this now as like, I really enjoy it, but I also see it as like fuel kind of thing as well. Like tomorrow I'm like, okay, good. And then that means I can probably do quite a good bike session. Or like, okay, tomorrow I'm going to hit check, like, I'm not going to do legs because I might feel a bit sluggish. I'm like, no, I'm going to do legs like with a big belly foot or something. But like, oh, dude, I can do chest, if we international chest day tomorrow, I'll do chest and like work on that. And that's how I kind of mentalize it as well a bit. But like I said, I don't like fear. I think before, previously, I had like a fear, like, oh, carbs or this or that. But I think I've learned a lot more about nutrition as well. I think that kind of helps a little bit. I think the food reviewing and stuff like that, also knowing what goes in the food and like what's like there and like people with like healthy food and stuff like that. It's not like when you break it down in your body, it's like protein, fats, carbs. There's nothing exactly the same. Yeah, there's not really that much more to it. It's the micronutrients to like get your greens in and stuff like that is definitely key. But apart from that, you can have it in any which way you want.
Yeah, and I think also respecting the process.
Yeah,
because you know, you eat it, you enjoy the food, and then you burn it, and then that alone is a bit of excitement for you. It's euphoric, isn't it? When you're just like gone for like a run or
yeah.
out that natural high.
Yeah, yeah.
So you can't cheat yourself with not doing that, and then the win-win is that. You get to do this all over again without the guilt.
You should have done that beer.
I feel like Laura should drink the beer. Well, you know, this guy's gonna drink the beer. Guys, come on.
Have a guys.
What crazy stuff are you gonna do with the beer?
Has anyone ever heard of a Manchester Passyunk Snooter?
No.
Basically, what you do is you crack the beer.
Oh my god.
But why?
Okay, I'm not gonna lie.
Didn't go to plan.
I wasn't expecting it to shoot up that far.
Why?
Did you let go of your nose?
Right on my nose.
Showing off his nose.
That's such a cool way to
finish off the food. Wow. I was not expecting that.
Yeah, I've never seen that before.
So, let me. This is the Passyunk Pale Ale. It's our own pale ale from Sandbrook's Brewery. It tastes great with your Philly cheesesteak. It's bloody beautiful. Just don't do it the way that just happened with me right there, which was completely unplanned, by the way.
Why would anyone plan that?
I don't know.
Guys, all the food here is amazing. If you want your babies, you can get your babies. If you want your halal munch, you can come get your halal munch. We're all here, it's a wee community. Come down, have some good food, feel the vibes. See guys smoke some IPA and catch us on the next one. You'll find me at oowee.eat on Instagram and all the other socials. Just got a new YouTube out, so I'd appreciate if you like and subscribe, all that good stuff. And Man Like Max versus food.
That was great, man. It was really good meeting you. And it was really good, guys, you snorting all the beer up your nose. That was a great one to have us.
Fellas, no, thank you very much for coming down. I really appreciate it. It's good to have you here, and I'm glad you enjoyed the food.
Yeah, definitely. And we'll be back, maybe back for more reviews, some challenges, mix it up, the content. It's going to be wild.
Cool.
All right, do you have a sign off? Go and do that. Do it.
Ooh-wee.
I love it. It's so good.
Wait. Let's do it. Ooh-wee.
Love it. Yes, man. That was brilliant. That's just what I needed.
What happened there, fellas? I was on camera, I was like that, just going, oh, I can't just let this flow out.
Yeah, yeah,
and I'm like, nah, fuck this, no.
Like, you really redeemed yourself, because I thought it was actually right, cracked up and snorted.
Yeah, yeah, but anyone like, would just, it's like, oh, God, just put it in your mouth.
Years of
my nose.
Years of experience.